Chapter 5, get customers to like your page. So now we're talking about cost-effective social proof. Now, one thing that's important to understand is likes by themselves do not equal customers. They do, however, equal social proof. Okay, we talked about social proof in the earlier chapter and the importance of social proof. So letting people know that if lots of other people have liked your page, there's probably something good there. There's probably some real quality. And that's the first step of getting a customer, because it's very inexpensive to get lots of people who are genuinely interested in your topic, who live all over the world, to like your page. And so in this case, you can see we've gotten 258,000 likes. This page generates $50,000 a month in recurring revenue. Here's our Costa Rica page, 574,000 likes. And this, we did 1.5 million in sales to our eco-friendly Costa Rica wellness community. Here's another example. We've got 1.3 million likes on our yoga page. And this page generates about $8,000 a month in recurring sales, where we refer traffic to the people in looking for yoga retreats in Costa Rica. So that works out really well. So the global ad secret is how we go about helping you get your Facebook page likes, okay? So take a look at this for a second. So when we do the global ad secret, the way to do it is to set up a Facebook page likes campaign. So how do you set up a Facebook page likes campaign? Well, first thing is you go to your Facebook ads manager. All right, so if you've never been to your Facebook ads manager, you don't know how to find it, go to facebook.com/ads/manager. All right, go to facebook.com/ads/manager. And what you do is you click on the green create ad button. All right, click on the green create ad button. And then it's going to take you to this page. It's going to say, what is your main objective. And your main objective is to promote your page. That's called a page likes campaign. And it's going to default to this spot on the top that says auction. And just leave it at the default. Pretty much whenever you see a default, almost all the time, with very few exceptions, leave it at the default. Okay, so you click promote your page. You click continue. And then it takes you to the first step. So the first step of this page is you're going to choose your audience, all right? So you'll put in your Facebook page, and if you only have one page, it'll default to your Facebook page, and then you put in your audience. Now, here's the global ad secret. Here's what really works. If you choose your countries, and one way to find a good list of countries is to go to Google and type in countries by per capita GDP. That stands for gross domestic product. It just means how much, on average, people who live in that country earn. So, for example, the number one earning country in the world is Qatar. People in Qatar, on average, earn $132,000 a year. People in Luxembourg, on average, earn $98,000 a year. Singapore, Brunei, Kuwait, Norway, and United Arab Emirates. Now, I'm not saying that all of your customers live in Qatar. That's not what I'm saying. What I am saying, though, is that you may not have considered some of these affluent countries as places where people could genuinely be interested in you, what it is that you do, your products, your programs, your services. And what I've discovered is that I actually have customers in every one of those countries. I have customers in 56 countries, including Qatar, Luxembourg, Singapore, Brunei, Kuwait. Blew my mind when somebody from the United Arab Emirates and San Marino and Switzerland and Hong Kong purchased my information programs, but that is precisely what happened. So what we're doing here is we're going for real people who are genuinely interested in what it is that you do, okay? So we can choose countries from all over the world, okay? So, I usually choose, you want to take a screenshot of this, you can look at the countries that I have on the left side, Australia, Belgium, Canada, Germany, Spain, Finland, France, UK, Ireland, Italy, Luxembourg, Netherlands, Norway, New Zealand, Sweden, and the United States. If I only advertise in the United States is the most expensive place to advertise in. And remember, we're not going for customers yet. We're not there yet. We're just going for cost-effective social proof. So we want real people who are genuinely interested in what it is that we do. So how do you find those people who are interested in what it is that you do? Well, in the interest section, this is where you start to type in what it is that you do and what your web page or your Facebook page is about. So in my case, it's about social media marketing. Okay, so I would type in social media marketing, or in this example, I might type in viral marketing or web traffic. And the cool thing about Facebook is once you type one of these things in, it'll make suggestions on other topics. So what you're going to be doing is you're going to be targeting real people who live all over the world who are genuinely interested in what it is that you do. Okay, so in this case, this comes up to a huge audience, 39 million people. Okay, and when we do the global ad secret, we want a very large audience, because a large global audience is going to help you have a much lower cost per like. Okay, and we're not looking for fake likes. We don't want to do anything like that. We want real people who are genuinely interested in what it is that we do, who live all over the world, and we can get those people cost effectively. And this part is interest targeting. The next step will be placement. And again, leave it at the default. So the default is going to be automatic placements. Leave it at the default. And now you can type in your daily budget. Start with a $5 daily budget. If you haven't done this before, start with a $5 daily budget. Remember what I said in an earlier chapter, where you might have to try 10 different versions of your ads to find one that really is going to work. But again, the nice thing is Facebook makes that really easy for you. So all the defaults on here, things like bid amount and optimization and when you get charged and ad scheduling, delivery type, all that stuff, leave that at the default. You can choose your ad set name down at the bottom. And then you get to select your images. So Facebook's done a really good job here by giving you awesome images to choose from. So you would click add more images, okay? And now you can go to their free stock images. So in this case, I typed in nature. And this is powered by Shutterstock, and it just pulls up all these beautiful photos. You can just go in and check, 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 select. You don't have to worry about permission. You already have permission to use those photos. And you click done. Okay, that's it. That's all you need to do. And now you have 6 versions of one ad. Okay, I'm going to recommend you get at least 10, so you'll want to do this twice, but you'll want to get at least, you'll start with these 6. Okay, and then keep the text short. So a lot of people like to try to write a really long bit of text in their ads. Mine are always really short for a global ad secret page likes campaign. I want to write it really short. Like customers, ? And then this beautiful photo. That's it. That's my whole page likes campaign ad. So let's do a quick recap. Global ad secret. Number 1, running Facebook page likes ad campaign to build cost-effective social proof. Number 2, targeting real people who are genuinely interested in what it is that you do. Number 3, live in countries all over the world, okay? Real people. So a lot of times people will say to me, oh, well, you know what? I'm a chiropractor and I can only work with people who, you know, live in my zip code. Why would I want, people in Canada and Australia and the United Kingdom to like my page? Well, again, if your page only has 7 likes and another chiropractor's page has 7,000, people are going to make an automatic assumption that that other chiropractor is better just because they have more likes. So what this does is it gets real people who are genuinely interested in chiropractic work, real people who really love what it is that you do, to like your page. That is very positive. I view that as very positive. And it's okay that they live in countries all over the world. And the last thing I'll mention is our Costa Rica page has over 500,000 likes. When we did our sales to our Costa Rica wellness community, there was only 7 customers. So you say, wait, 500,000 likes and only 7 customers? You got 0.0000% customer, 1% of the page likes are customers. And I say, yeah, but we made $1.5 million in sales. So do you really care? So the point is, you want real people who genuinely are interested in what it is that you do to like your page. And it is okay if they live all over the world. All right. So let's move on. I'll see you in chapter 6, where we're going to talk about the science of sharing. All right. See you there.